We will solve Irodov problem 164, chapter 1. In this problem, there is a disk, small mass here at the height h. It slides down on a smooth surface without friction. It comes to this plank of mass capital M. The plank can slide on this surface without friction, but there is a friction between the disk and the plank. We have to find out what is the work done by the frictional force on the mass M. We have to do it by two methods. One is by taking the frame of reference as this, the stationary frame of reference. When these two bodies contact each other, the small mass is moving with a velocity u and the capital mass is at rest. There is some motion, relative motion between them, and some energy is lost because of friction. And finally, this body moves as a unit with a velocity v. In such problems, as far as conservation of momentum is concerned, forget the intermediate steps. Forget that. Just take the initial momentum and the final momentum. Here there is some energy loss, just leave it as far as conservation of momentum is concerned. So mu would be equal to m plus mv, where u is the velocity of mass when it comes down, and u will be equal to root twice gh. How this has come? Half mu square will be the kinetic energy of this mass, and potential energy was mgh, so that is why u has come as twice gh square root. Now the v would be equal to mu upon m plus m. What is the kinetic energy of the system? The kinetic energy would be half m plus m into v square, which would be equal to 1 upon 2 m plus m, m square u square upon m plus m whole square, which would be equal to m square u square upon twice m plus m. This is the kinetic energy of the system. What was the initial energy? Initial, this is the final energy. Initial energy was the potential energy with reference to this point, and that is mgh. What is the value of u? U is twice gh square root. This gets cancelled. So this is m square gh upon m plus m. And this is mgh. So difference in energy is equal to mgh minus m square gh upon m plus m. This becomes mgh into m plus m minus m upon m plus m. So it becomes mmgh upon m plus m is the loss in energy, and this loss in energy is nothing but the work done by the frictional force. Now we have to do the other part of the problem. That is, if we take a different frame of reference, what is the difference in the result? What is the difference in the outcome? Now take this as a reference frame. Now just imagine few things which are happening. The mass and the bigger mass, they are in contact. Till such time they finally move with some common velocity, there is a relative movement between them for some time. That time be delta t. Now a force will act on it, that is a friction force. And friction force will act on the lower mass like this. what would be the acceleration of the lower mass Planck, this Planck, because of friction force, it would be ma is equal to f, which will be a is equal to f upon m is the acceleration of this. Now take this motion relative to the Planck. Since the Planck is a reference frame which itself is moving with acceleration a, and whenever the reference frame on which a body is put moves with an acceleration a, there is a pseudo force which acts on this body, which is in opposite direction. So one force acting on this body is this ma, another force is the frictional force. So these are the forces which are acting on the smaller body as compared to this frame of reference. In this frame of reference, these are the two forces acting on it. So what is the acceleration of mass in this frame of reference? Mass into acceleration relative, because it is in this frame of reference, would be equal to the pseudo force ma plus frictional force ma plus f. What is the value of f? Is ma plus ma, or we can write as a m plus m. So the relative acceleration would be this. This is the relative acceleration of the body with respect to this frame of reference. And we can also eliminate a. A is equal to, what is the frictional force? Is mu mg upon m. Or we can simply write in terms of f also. A is f upon capital M. So it becomes ar is equal to f upon m m into m plus m. So it is, sorry, small f. This is the frictional force. Now our job is almost done. What is the relationship between the distance traveled, the velocity and the acceleration? We know v square is equal to u square minus twice as, or plus twice as. In this case, when the body is moving on this bigger body mm with an acceleration ar which is negative, which is retarding, because the forces, the frictional force and the pseudo force ma, both were opposing its motion, so acceleration is retarding actually. So you will have to use minus here, and final velocity is zero. We want to know what is the distance traveled by this Planck, by this mass on the Planck, till such time it comes to rest. Till such time it comes to rest, it is facing an acceleration ar, which is this. This is the retardation. This is which is opposing its motion. And it will come to stand still with respect to this, and its final velocity is zero. Its initial velocity with respect to this Planck is just when it starts the contact, and which is nothing but the u, which was twice gh under root, was the initial velocity. So here the final velocity is zero. Zero is equal to twice gh minus twice a r into s. So a r into s is equal to twice gh upon 2. It is equal to gh is a r into s. What is the value of a r? Is f m m into m plus m is equal to g h into s. It is coming like this. What is work done by frictional force? Work done by frictional force is nothing but the frictional force which is acting on this body when it is, when there is relative motion. Same force is acting in both the bodies, and we know the distance which this body travels is s. as we have found here, distance traveled with respect to this. Please note, this is the distance which is traveled in reference to this frame of reference. That is why we have taken the relative acceleration. Acceleration in this frame of reference. So distance traveled in this frame of reference is S. Force acting is F. So work done will be F into S. So we found the value of Fs. Fs is equal to GH MM upon M plus M is the answer, which is same as we obtained earlier. So the reference frame doesn't make any difference to this problem. Thank you.